Donald Trump may be a lot of things, but is obese one of them? Is Donald Trump obese? According to his most recent annual physical exam, Donald weighed 244 pounds. But we need more than the number on a scale to know if he is obese. One of the most common ways to classify if someone is overweight or obese is to use a BMI calculator or chart. So first, you need to figure out someone's body mass index, or BMI. Essentially, BMI considers someone's weight in relation to their height. Once the BMI is known, then you can use a chart to see in which percentile your BMI falls. There are many charts and calculators to choose from to figure out one's BMI. I will provide links to those from the CDC in the description of this video. Donald reportedly weighs 244 pounds, but we also need his height to calculate his BMI. His physical exam claims he is 6'3". After entering the numbers into the CDC Adult BMI Calculator, the results show that Donald's BMI is 30.5, indicating that his weight is in the obese category. Donald may be obese, but that is far from uncommon here in the US for both adults and children. This video will summarize the recent obesity statistics for adults and children. First, let's look at the prevalence of obesity amongst adults. The CDC has released the 2019 Adult Obesity Prevalence Maps. The maps show self-reported adult obesity prevalence by race, ethnicity, and location. The 2019 maps show that obesity impacts some groups more than others. All states and territories had more than 20% of adults with obesity. Six states had an obesity prevalence of 35% or higher among non-Hispanic white adults. 15 states had an obesity prevalence of 35% or higher among Hispanic Latinx adults. 34 states and the District of Columbia had an obesity prevalence of 35% or higher among non-Hispanic black adults. The Midwest, 33.9%, and South, 33.3%, had the highest prevalence of obesity, followed by the Northeast, 29%, and the West, 27.4%. The prevalence of adult obesity here in California was 26.2%. Obesity decreased by level of education. Adults without a high school degree or equivalent had the highest self-reported obesity, 36.2%, followed by high school graduates, 34.3%, adults with some college, 32.8%, and college graduates, 25%. Young adults were half as likely to have obesity as middle-aged adults. Adults aged 18 to 24 years had the lowest self-reported obesity, 18.9%, compared to adults aged 45 to 54 years who had the highest prevalence, 37.6%. Combining data from 2017 through 2019, non-Hispanic black adults had the highest prevalence of self-reported obesity, 39.8%, followed by Hispanic Latinx adults, 33.8%, and non-Hispanic white adults, 29.9%. On the screen is a map of the prevalence of self-reported obesity among non-Hispanic white adults. The prevalence of obesity in white adults in California was 23.9%. On the screen is a map of the prevalence of self-reported obesity among Hispanic Latinx adults. The prevalence of obesity in Hispanic Latinx adults in California was 32.9%. On the screen is a map of the prevalence of self-reported obesity among non-Hispanic black adults. The prevalence of obesity in black adults in California was 35.6%. For children and teens, BMI is age and sex specific and is often referred to as BMI for age. A child's weight status is determined using an age and sex specific percentile for BMI rather than the BMI categories used for adults. This is because children's body composition varies as they age and varies between boys and girls. Therefore, BMI levels among children and teens need to be expressed relative to other children of the same age and sex. A classification of underweight refers to a child's BMI that is less than the fifth percentile. A classification of normal or healthy weight refers to a child's BMI that is between the 5th percentile to less than the 85th percentile. A classification of overweight refers to a child's BMI that is between the 85th to less than the 95th percentile. A classification of obese refers to a child's BMI that is in the 95th percentile or greater. For example, a 10-year-old boy of average height, 56 inches, who weighs 102 pounds, would have a BMI of 22.9. This would place the boy in the 95th percentile for BMI, and he would be considered as obese. This means that the child's BMI is greater than the BMI of 95% of 10-year-old boys in the reference population. In 2015-2016, the prevalence of obesity among U.S. youth was 18.5%. Overall, the prevalence of obesity among adolescents 12 to 19 years of age was 20.6%, and school-age children 6 to 11 years of age was 18.4%. The prevalence of obesity in preschool-age children 2 to 5 years of age was 13.9%. School-aged boys 20.4% had a higher prevalence of obesity than preschool-aged boys 14.3%. Adolescent girls 20.9% had a higher prevalence of obesity than preschool-aged girls, 13.5%. There are differences in the prevalence of obesity among youth of different races and ethnicities. The prevalence of obesity among non-Hispanic black youth, 22%, and Hispanic youth, 25.8%, was higher than among both non-Hispanic white youth, 14.1%, and non-Hispanic Asian youth, 11%. The pattern among girls was similar to the pattern in all youth. The prevalence of obesity was 25.1% in non-Hispanic black girls, 23.6% in Hispanic girls, 13.5% in non-Hispanic white girls, and 10.1% in non-Hispanic Asian girls. The pattern among boys was similar to the pattern in all youth, except Hispanic boys, 28%, had a higher prevalence of obesity than non-Hispanic black boys, 19%. There are differences in the prevalence of obesity among youth of different socioeconomic statuses. The prevalence of obesity decreased with increasing levels of education of the head of the household among children and adolescents 2 to 19 years of age. Obesity prevalence was 18.9% among children and adolescents aged 2 to 19 years in the lowest income group, 19.9% among those in the middle income group, and 10.9% among those in the highest income group. Obesity prevalence was lower in the highest income group among non-Hispanic, Asian, and Hispanic boys. Obesity prevalence was lower in the highest income group among non-Hispanic white, non-Hispanic Asian, and Hispanic girls. Obesity prevalence did not differ by income among non-Hispanic black girls.